Hey guys, Hawt Karl here, and today I'm playing Control with McMarshal. We are doing a Control game which is found in our first edition tournament pack. You can find that on our website, and you can find this really cool map on our website too, under the download section. So in Control, each Merc kill is going to be worth one victory point, and at the end of the game, which is turn 7, or after 50 minutes of play, you determine who controls zones based on who has the amount of the most Mercs in that zone. So if we look, we've got three zones here. I actually have marks on my board here. We've got a zone right here, a zone right here, and a zone right here, and they extend across the board. Each far end zone is worth 2 victory points, and the center zone is worth 3 victory points. So at turn 7, you look at the board state, and you collect victory points based on who controls what zones, and then each merc kill, whoever has the most victory points wins the game. Alright, so first thing we're going to do is deployment. So we're going to roll off here. Highest gets to choose to deploy first or second. I have an 8.
I have a
8. Alright, who's deploying first?
I guess I will.
Before we start the first turn, there's no objectives we deploy because we're doing control. I get one free move.
And then I place my bounty.
Yes, then you place your bounty. One NP. One NP. And of course, you don't get a snap to cover with this because you only get a snap to cover per activation, and this is just a free move before any activations take place. Alright, cool, that's my move. Place your bounty back.
I am placing my bounty on the sniper.
The sniper, ooh.
The sniper.
Ooh, alright.
He's a marked man.
Alright. Okay. I know what I'm doing. I've got my 8-5, you got an 8-5 too, right?
Yeah.
Alright, are you ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, bound! Alright. I am bounding to my demolition 2 reaction 5.
And you're worth in 1, I'm guessing.
Oh, that's right! Traps are a problem, aren't they? Yeah, thank you for reminding me. So actually, I will not.
Ooh.
Thank you. Thank you for that.
You're welcome.
So the demolitions guy here is immune to traps, and anybody within one card length of him is also immune to traps. That's not explicitly written on the card, but that is in fact the rule from the mouth of Brian Schotten, straight into your hearts. So I will not be bounding with the Calypso. I will be instead just doing a regular move. And you bounded to who?
To the Eagle.
Okay.
Initiatives to 7.
1 MP. I'll do 2 MP here, and then I'm going to snap to cover here. Alright, so my next is a 5.
My next is 7, so my Eagle and my Bounded Marshal will go.
Alright, so I bounded, so he's going to get a total of 3 MP.
So it is worth noting that Texico do not trigger their own traps.
2.
Yeah, might as well. I guess I really can't snap up.
No, you can, because this is that's cover right there. So you can along it, yeah.
So I'll just snap up on the wall there. And then at the same time, my Eagle, I believe, is going to fire and shoot at your sniper. So that's 1 MP.
Oh, he spends 1 MP to go up in the air, and then he spends another MP to move there, right?
No, you can move laterally.
Right, but it costs an MP to move up that lateral distance. You spend 1 MP, you can jump 6 ER in the air.
So I always interpreted that you can kind of jump and move it.
So what move laterally means is, actually, can we leave your card there so we know where he is? What that would mean is you can spend an MP and move like this.
Yep.
Well, you'd have to spend 2 MP in this case. You can move across elevation expanses moving laterally. But in this case,
you would actually have to perform an elevation change to get on top. Make sense?
Yeah.
So from your position, you'd have to spend one of you go. Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh.
Yeah, I always interpreted that you could just go whoop.
No, you have to move up first. That's why it says can move two cards in the air for one MP.
Okay.
So and each card is ER3.
In that case.
So that's two MP right there.
Just to take that back.
You want a fire move or just regular move?
I think I can see your sniper if I go right here.
Yeah, I can see him.
You got me. Half cover, elevation, nines. With your fire move. Hang on, are you within a card length of your leader?
I believe I am, so eight.
He's on ER3, but we measure with a card length up to ER3. If there's a difference of at least ER4, you can't measure the card like that. So you're looking at eights.
Oh,
nothing
on.
Today.
Two twos. Swing and a miss.
All right, I've got a five.
Where's my... come on, dice.
So let's see. I think, because let's see, what are we talking about these stairs here? Because this is going to be ER3, right? So these stairs will get you up. I'm wondering, if I'm on the stairs, could I see you? What do you think, if I'm on the stairs?
I think you would be able to. I think I'd still get half cover. Like,
yeah, you definitely get half cover.
Yeah. But you could totally see me.
And then because we're both on the stairs, we'd be on the same elevation, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to fire and move. So I'm going to move.
Yeah, totally. When if you get on the stairs, you can totally see me.
Two
running
MP.
Running and gunning me.
Over here. And, snap just a little bit. And I'm going to take my shot at you. I start at FN5. Fire move makes it a 7. Half cover makes it an 8. So I get one shot with my rifle at 8. Nothing, but worth a try, right?
Always worth a try.
I have a 4 next, and that's my sniper. Now, if I could see you, if you could see me, I can see you with my sniper.
Tote.
I'm going to let it rip. I'm going to fire at you.
Alrighty.
So I start at FN5. My leader gives me +1, so I need force. You have elevation and half cover, so I need sixes. 50%. Nope, not today. But then I will, I suppose I'll just snap to cover.
Oh yeah, I forgot you can actually hurt me.
Yes, I can hurt you, watch out.
But at least I don't take falling damage. So.
No. My leader is next to the 3.
I have a 3-5 and a 3-4.
I've got a 3-4, so go ahead with your 3-5. That's the Jaguar, right?
Jaguar. All right. I don't know if I should bound him or not. Yeah, I'm gonna bound down to my leader. Oh, can I bound down to 3-4? Or
if you can bound down to anybody who's going after you.
Okay, so yeah.
So people who have the same initiative die roll can bound to somebody with a lower initiative.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I'm sorry, lower reaction.
Yeah, lower reaction. So yeah, he's gonna bound down to the lower reaction at 4. So we're all moving at the same time.
All right. Cool.
Cool. No. So my leader and my Jaguar did bound. So he's gonna go around. One. Two. Snap. Jaguar, so then then we're all going at the same time. What are you doing?
I've got a 3-4. I know what I'm doing. Ready? I think we're just both gonna move.
Yeah, we're both
gonna move. Alright. Actually, I'm gonna bound to my demolition because I'm within a card of him.
Nice.
So, I'm waiting for a 2-5.
I'm just moving over here. Would that be considered moving through my own merc to get over there?
No,
or?
Because. No. What you do is. Yeah, actually, just use the hash mark. It's much easier in this case.
Well, that's what
you were not moving through your own merc.
Yeah,
and you're making a direct line.
Yeah,
and you could actually move up this far because base start, base end.
Yeah, exactly.
I used a snap to get through there.
Yeah,
if you're trying to.
I'm just finishing myself over here.
Okay,
cool. Getting into position.
I have a 2-5.
So go right ahead.
That's my demolition. My demolition is going to move 2 MP. And I'm not moving through that wall. I'm moving just past it. 1 MP. 2 MP.
And then shoot, I messed that up.
Snap to cover.
Did not mean to do that.
Where do I want to charge my leader? He's got 3 MP here. He can just go running. Watch that heavy, though. He's going to go. 1 MP. Hash marks here. 2 MP. 3 MP.
snap to cover.
Oh, snap. I'm just going to move.
All right. Oh, they're going to set up a defense over there, huh?
No.
All right, so that concludes round one. Nothing really going on over on that side of the board. All right, so let's start round two. Yeah, I'll use be my guest. I'm going to switch the 9 and the 2 on the sniper. So my sniper's a 9, he'll be going first.
What's he doing?
He's probably just going to move.
What you going to do? What you going?
He's going to move 1 MP. He's going to move a 2nd MP. Route over in this direction, man. With a snap to cover, touching that corner there. So now he's actually snapping to it. All right, that's my 9. Looks like you're going with...
I have a 6.
Five. Yeah, go ahead. Let it rip.
Jaguar. He's going to move and shoot at your Wavefinder, your Calypso.
Okay.
He's going to just go...
Alright, so the question is,
nines,
will that be half cover? Because what we do is we take both sides of the base, and we're going to draw a direct line connecting to my sides of the base. So if at any point...
Yeah, you're half screen right now.
Okay, so that'll be half, so that would actually make it tens. Because you start at 7, fire move is at 9.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Half cover is at 10.
I think, yeah. I don't know what I was doing. Come on. Oh, that was a good roll.
Oh, yeah, that was really good. Not quite.
And then he's just gonna go.
All right, so I'm gonna move. Cat says he's going on Overwatch.
I am going on Overwatch.
I'm gonna give you that peeky eye token. That token looks so angry, doesn't it? Like
it's more creepy than anything.
Here's what I'm gonna do.
And this, since at the same time it doesn't trigger.
One MP. Correct. No, that's correct. Well, the way that this works is you look at the chain of occurrence. So you all have a cool card that should come with your.
I know the nuances of Overwatch, but I'm saying since it's.
So the way this would work, if we look at the chain of occurrence right here, you start with suppression, Overwatch, action. So that would mean that your Overwatch hits.
Yeah.
And it could hit my action, but I started in a position that you couldn't draw a line of sight to, therefore you didn't see me start my action.
But if you end in my line of sight, then it goes off.
No, you only Overwatch only triggers at the start of an action. If I come in and end...
But I thought if you did another MP, though, that would start it.
Not MPs, just the action itself.
Oh.
Overwatch only hits actions, just like suppression.
Oh, okay.
So now I'm going to snap to cover here. And lastly, move another MP right into this little house. Actually move.
Eugh, I don't like this.
Coming to get you. You gotta be your best friend. Alright, I've got a 5-4. Alright, so my 5-4 bounds to my demolition.
Gee, good.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so my Marshal, I believe. I was gonna even move it.
Get out of the shot. Get out of here. What is he doing?
Yeah, because I can't get in a close.
This is tough. What do you think you're gonna do?
Well, I can't get in close and shoot.
Because that short range bonus on those pistols is nasty.
Yeah. But and it's worth it to move if I can get in close, but I can't get in close. I might as well just shoot, to be honest. So at 7.
8.
8. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, might as well. Because otherwise it'd be nothing.
9 and 8.
Oh, there's 1.
Oh, armor brick check. Good.
Ah.
But I do take a blood.
First blood.
Okay.
Sorry. So I snapped, and then I'm just going to hold for +2 to my initiative next round.
Well, with that, what's your last? A 1?
1.
Ah! Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to bravely start with my demolition. He's going to move 1 MP, and then he's going to move 2 MP.
Trust the system.
He'll be right there. That's a good spot for him.
So what I did here was I actually did not move the full card. I stopped right here. If you look at the elevation section of the rulebook, you are allowed to stop your movement flush with any elevation change. You're allowed to move up to it and stop. I guess that represents your merc moving along the wall or something. I don't know. You shouldn't have to move the full card. But that's the way that you can get around it. If you're out in the open, you've got to move the full card. You don't have a choice. But here, I need to progress the whole way. I just stop. All right. Next, I have the... Oh, you know what? I did that out of order. Because I had a 2-6 here. Yeah. But the only thing he's going to do... I'll just jump to him really quickly. He's going to snap, and he's going to drop his turret.
No!
Directly in front of
him. Oh, that's annoying.
So that she's blocked and can't be seen. All right.
I can clearly see you.
Turret, oh, no, the turret occupies the space of ER2.
So annoying.
Just like the behemoth occupies the space of ER3.
Yeah.
Which is also silly. All right, so my leader, he's going to start with a snap to cover right here. He's going to move... He's going to move 1 MP, stop with the wall, because that's a wall, he has to stop for it. Move a 2nd MP. And he's going to move a 3rd. Bada boom.
Bada boom.
Turn 90 at the end of that.
So my heavy gunner is the last to go. I believe he's going to...
No targets. Going overwatch.
Pretty much. Overwatch time.
Woo! Right here. That sees an angry eye.
The angry eye.
I don't know why Merce wants to make them so angry. All right. Okay, so that's it. That wraps up. Was that turn 2?
Yeah.
That was turn 2. I've got my turret, so that'll kick on next turn. I've got to roll a separate initiative for that. It'll be the last one I roll. This is awesome! Alright.
It's alright. I have
8-5. It's okay. 8-5? Let me look at your initiatives here. Alright, so I'm going to start off with my 10 reaction 5. That's my demolition. He's going to perform a snap to cover right there. And then he's going to suppress.
Nice.
Alright, cool. Go ahead with your Jaguar.
What is he going to do? Tell you what he's going to do. He's going to bound down to my leader.
Alright, bounce the leader.
I have plus 2 this.
Oh yeah, that's right. What's he now? 5? Ooh, five. Scary.
So my next highest is 5s now.
Alright, well I got a 6 with my leader.
So your 6 goes. What you going to do?
I'm going to perform a move action.
Alright.
And that's going to look like this. Turn 90. I'll have him snap to cover right here. Snap.
Such a dynamic snap.
Very dynamic. Brian would cry if he saw this. That's my 2nd MP right there. Alright, I'm in the house. Alright, so here's what I'm going to do. Snap to cover, right there along the train. And I'm going to, we don't have any more Overwatch tokens, but I'll get these pointing fingers. But you know, I want to kill things that way. So I'm on Overwatch right there.
Yeah, two. Go around.
Oh, he's getting out of there.
1. And I'm not moving the full card length, so I'm just going to...
Stopping flush with the elevation change. Very nice, very nice.
So 2 MP.
Mm-hmm.
Because technically that's not a snap.
Oh, and at initiative 6, my turret leapt into action.
Okay. And my Jaguar is going to go...
Whoa. All right, I couldn't see with the demo, so that's going to be no suppression check necessary.
I have 1.
Oh, you've got 3 ones, so I've got my Wavefinder going.
Yeah, I rolled terrible, so...
So here's what I'm going to do with my Wavefinder. And here's a little trick I learned at Worlds. Mercs are dynamic models, so they can pass through tiny spaces.
Yeah.
Because even though that base is big, the Merc only occupies really a part of it. They can squeeze, they can shimmy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to snap along my buddy turret, and I'm going to fire and move. And I can actually spend one MP to leap through there. And now, am I in short range? I'm going to try to land shots now. That doesn't. I'm in short range. But you're going to have half cover. You're partially blocked by the stairs. So that's going to be FN 5, fire move, short range, half cover, elevation, one shot at 5. Nice.
All right, I'm gonna break at 4 up, I'm good. Armor does not break, he takes blood.
And then I'm going to dive over here.
I'm gonna get you.
And use a boo-boo.
Ready? His pride's a little wounded.
So I'm gonna move to a position where he can't see me, and he can't see me with this sniper. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm actually gonna move this right here, getting right in the camera's face. I'm gonna move one MP right there, and then I'll snap the cover here, and then I will move my second MP. Dive, dive, dive. So that's the spot that he can occupy, and he can in fact draw a line of sight. So I'm happy with that. But did I use my snap already? I did.
Yes.
I will stop flush with that elevation change right here, so you can't be targeted. Okay. All right, so I'm good. Have fun with your ones.
Eagle's going to continue remaining on Overwatch.
All right.
He has a good spot. And my Marshal is going to move and shoot.
All right, hang on. Right here, you declare a move and shoot.
Yep.
Overwatch triggers because I can see you.
Yep.
You move half your MP rounded down before I shoot. Now, you have a fire move, so when you do that, you actually have one MP.
Yeah.
Half of that MP rounded down.
So you go off right now.
Is zero. So I fire right now.
Yeah.
I start at FN 8. You are half cover, and I've got elevation, so I just need two shots at 8. So I've got this great tool here. Check this out. You can probably get this on our website later on our store. Ba-boom! Look at that. I'm not quite sure still if you plug it in or you go in here. Either way, I'm not in short range. But there we go, that's how that works. And I center directly on you. When it's an Overwatch attack, you go directly on. If it's just a Merc firing normally, you can actually place that template anywhere on here. But here I gotta center it. Two shots, looking at 8. Nothing. All right.
Alrighty. There we go. So
you know what? I should have fired at you after you started your shoot action. That would have been a lot smarter because then you would have been in short range. No cover.
He dives out of the way of the bullets, and he will shoot.
I think that's at 4s, because you start at FN 5.
5.
Fire move is 7. Short range, no cover, so 4s.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, one hit. All right, I take another blood, because I actually didn't track that there. Didn't go along.
Yeah.
In armor failure check, at 4 up. He's good.
All right.
She, excuse me. That's a woman. All right.
And my last is heavy gunner. I can't see your Calypso, or else I'd try. Well, actually, if I snap back, I can. Like that.
Are you in leadership range?
I don't know.
I'll have half cover at least.
I am.
So all right.
8s.
Yep, 8s.
Yeah. Come on, baby shine. One hit.
All right. Remember, okay. Failure check? Good.
Dang. That's fun. I have 10 with my Jaguar.
I don't have that. I have a 7. Let me think really quickly if I want to be my guest anything.
I am not
I'm going to be my guest in this manner, giving my Calypso a 6 and my Sniper a 4.
Okay.
You are in suppression, so you have to roll a suppression check. So you get minus 1 and plus 1 all rolls in there.
Yeah, he's on suppressing. So I'm going to stay put and take pot shots off at him.
All right, suppression check first.
Suppression check, I'm good.
All right, so you're at plus 1 FN.
So 7, 8, 9.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
There's my jag. Come on, baby.
Oh,
ah, no.
Nope.
No dice.
Ha! No dice.
My next is 5.
I've got a 7 with my Wavefinder.
You're 7 good.
So I've got this cool move. In our meta, it's referred to as the Karl Twirl. And today I'm going to show you the Karl Twirl. The Karl Twirl is all about getting behind your opponent to exploit the best firing number possible. I don't know if this is a good idea because this turret might end up shooting me. So what I'm going to do is just take the risk anyway and go for the Karl Twirl. That guy can't fire move, so I'm not very scared of that. So let me just check my movement here. He's going to be a fire move action. First of all, I am in fact in snapping distance of this, so I will snap to cover here. I can walk through that spot here.
Oh, I wish I was an elder archer. Oh, I can't.
Oops. Excuse me. I will take this right here, striking the wall with my body, turning 90 degrees. Am I in melee range? I think I am. I think, give your dog.
Yeah.
Arf, arf. That is in melee range by just a tad. So that means I can't fire. But I will commit to another move. I will move over here, ending flush with the elevation change, this wall here. You're in short range, rear, and from here you actually, well, you'll have half cover. Well, actually, I am claiming that cover because I'm within base length of it. You are not, so that means that I actually control the cover. I can, like, peek around it and shoot.
Yeah.
If we are both within a base length, we both control the cover, we both benefit from half, even when we're that close. So in this case, I start at FN5, I fire move, rear, short range, no cover. Two. One shot. Gotcha. Take a blood.
Oh, armor fails too.
Hooray. All right. So he's a two.
Good.
That's good for me.
Well, yeah, but not good for me.
All right.
The turret only triggers on mine.
The turret only triggers on mine, because I think the idea is they have, like, beacons in their suits that say, don't shoot at this.
Yeah.
But they will shoot at you.
Yeah.
So I've got a six with my Calypso.
Keep going.
What's the courage on your eagle?
Five up.
Five up. So I'm wondering at what point you can't see me on this truck. Because it's that tall, right? So if you're up here, how close do I need to be for you to not see me? Within like a short card length? If I perform a movement, at what point, because of the elevation of this truck, so you'd actually be up here?
You'd have to end your movement, yeah. It'd
probably within
be,
short range?
Yeah, it'd probably be right there.
So okay, you wouldn't be able to see me.
Yeah.
Otherwise, wouldn't be able to see me, but if I was over here, I'd probably have half cover at least.
Oh yeah, you'd definitely have half cover.
I'm just going to perform a move action. So I'm going to go off of the Overwatch state. I'm going to start with a snap to cover. I'm going to move my first MP. I think I can do it. One MP right here. You may now fire Overwatch shots, but...
Suppression.
Failed. All right, so I made that. Check there. Oh, actually, excuse me. All right, so suppression failed, so I can keep moving without a problem. I'm going to run right over here and think about things. Sit quietly. I'll go right here. Okay. He failed the suppression check.
Yeah.
I suppressed him.
He's suppressing me. Yeah.
Cameraman doesn't know what he's talking about.
back up a little bit so I can show it. All right, so with that, I was able to snap here, move one MP. After I moved half of my MP, Overwatch triggered when he saw me start my action. Overwatch actually occurred after I moved half my MP running down because I'm running. So he actually failed the suppression check. He's under suppression for my demo. Because of that, he couldn't actually fire the shots, and I was able to move the rest of the MP unimpeded. So there I am.
My leader is going to snap to actually get within card length.
Yes. Yeah. Because that would have made him pass that courage.
Yeah.
You still would have probably been a +3 to fire with that Overwatch, though, because moving target, suppression, and half cover.
I've rolled worse.
Yeah. I've also seen you roll 3 10s with that heavy gunner before and annihilate somebody.
Exactly.
All right.
I guess he's just gonna.
You've got tokens.
I guess I'm gonna. I might as well go on Overwatch.
All right. So I'm gonna give you the pointing fingers.
Yay.
Kill things that way.
Yeah.
All right. So we have 3 4 5s. This is gonna be a 3-way simultaneous action. So I've got to think about this for a minute. You've got your Marshal. I've got my Demolition, who's on suppression. I've got my Sniper, who's on Overwatch. So I know what I'm doing.
I know what I'm doing.
All right, so I'll declare overwatch, suppression over there, and I assume you are going to just shoot at my turret.
I'm shooting at your turret.
All right, so let's just resolve that right now.
So base 5, short range.
Short range makes it 3. No cover makes it 2. So you get 2 shots at 2 up. Now, at the same time, my turret is going to activate and unfortunately catch both you if we center it right on the Marshal and my Wayfinder. So you get to roll attacks against my Wayfinder too. So you roll attacks against me or the turret.
Yeah. So
that'll kill the turret. The turret will die.
Turret's gone.
But at the same time, turret fires overwatch at you. He starts at 8. You've got no cover. Short range. I need a 5. Got it. So that'll put the Marshal down. Then, over here, he's going to get hit too. Starts at 8. Elevation, half cover. So you need 8s to hit him. Don't put him down. Oh, he's down.
Boom.
Everything died over here.
nope, can't see it.
Ah, no for that.
That
last
attack was black. Can you imagine?
That last attack. The Marshal has an ability that allows him to get one attack after he dies. That's just one dice roll, not a combat ranged action. You just get one dice to roll.
One shot.
Still pretty nice to just put that last blood on somebody.
That's helped me out a lot.
It's way funny. All right, but over here, they, as I said, we're doing suppression overwatch. They're going to do a snap first, so I'm just going to snap out a little bit and use that suppression. Actually, I'm going to snap less. I'm going to snap about that far. The sniper is going to snap about that far. Stop it right there. And I think that is enough to see the eagle. He will go on overwatch. Where are we? Are out of Overwatch tokens. I'm gonna use these bullets. Bullets headed your way. I now have a 1 reaction 4.
I have a 3, 4, and I'm gonna bound down to my 1 reaction 5. My bounded heavy is going to go.
Who did the heavy bound to?
The eagle.
So when you have a bound target cannot perform any time-sensitive actions. Because the bound target is providing covering fire. So that means that the eagle can't go on overwatch.
Oh.
Time sensitive meaning I'm going to spend this round shooting at things. It actually says so under the bounding section. You cannot hold, you cannot suppress, and you cannot bound. So if you'd like, do you want to just pull that? You don't have to do the bound with him.
Well, no, I'm still going to do it. Because I was going to probably break overwatch anyway.
Okay.
So
shoot at something else. Shoot at something else.
So I'm going to sidestep. Turn 90 degrees, and then snap.
Snap would be a good, yeah, because that way you get around the corner. Oh, here he comes.
Wait there to snap forward later. And he is, I believe, going to move and shoot at your Calypso.
All right, first of all, suppression check.
Oh, yeah.
Pop.
I am within 1.
All right, so that's +1, so you're looking for a 4 up. Got it. You're -1 MP, and you're +1 to all rolls.
Here's what I'm going to do, actually. I'm not going to shoot. Or do I have to go through with it?
Well, if you declare a fire move, you do have to go through with it, because that was you declaring.
Okay.
So you are at 2 MP. Actually, you're at 1 MP with your fire move.
So I go.
Move laterally. Okay. And now you're going to shoot. So what's going to happen is overwatch from this guy, now that he sees you doing another action, because shooting is an action.
Yeah.
Moving is an action. Actually, I could fire you right now for the move, but I'm not. I'm going to let you not do that, and I'm going to hit your shooting action.
Okay.
Okay. Because the shooting, you'll still get moving target either way.
Yeah.
You'll get moving target either way, so I'll do it on the move action.
Okay.
That's when I'll do it. So you move half your MP, round it down.
Okay.
I'm going to try to shoot you. I am an FN 5. You are higher than me. You have half cover and you're moving target. I need an 8. Nope. Worth a try, though.
I have elevation, we have cover, so I can't slow, so 9s.
Also suppression, 10s.
Oh, 10s, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm safe. Okay. So in the end step, he will poop, drop on the ground.
He just drops down.
Alright, so last move here is my leader, and I'm not quite sure how this is going to go, but I'm going to try it. I'm going to snap to cover, snapping to this wall here. I'm going to move 1 MP here, and I'm wondering if I'll get to short range. I'm gonna try it. Come here, you.
Oh, yeah, you're gonna get tried.
Booyah.
Booyakasha.
Okay.
All right. So we're looking at the start of round five here. I have very average initiative with a 5-5-4-4. Pat has beat me three times, so he's going to start with a 9 on the Jaguar. Pat, what are you doing?
I am going to attempt to run and hit your demo.
Let's suppress it.
Yeah. No!
No.
Oh.
Gotcha.
Seriously?
You're trapped.
Seriously?
He's very scared. All right.
Stop rolling threes.
So, sevens. Two of them.
Two of them, same time. He's going to open up, I hear later.
Who is?
Might have a gunner.
All right, he cannot fire in short range.
Are you within short?
Yes, I am within short. Here's a... Check it out.
Yeah.
I don't even think a snap can get you out of range. If you snap, you want to check it? If you snap a full base back, because that's 30 millimeters, we're still in.
Oh, I forgot about
that's
that.
That's why it charged. You can't shoot it. That's the one thing. They're great at long range, but when I get that close, because that would have been great. That would have been 8, 6, half, even 7s. I mean, that's not bad.
What's your reaction?
Use your machete. My reaction is actually 8 with that shield, the melee attacks. I'm regular reaction 4, but the shield gives plus 4 reaction for the purposes of melee fights.
I'm going to snap up and then shoot at your Calypso within the 180.
Alright, so that's just a flat 9, isn't it? Because you're FN8 and that's half cover.
Yeah.
Alright, so flat 9s.
Flat 9s. Come on. Don't fail me. Oh, this is the same time.
They're acting simultaneously?
Yeah, they are.
Alright, so he's going to move and do that.
But he's just going to move.
Move, alright.
So I'll just move real quick.
MP.
And 2.
All right.
Then turn it there.
Cool.
And then, yeah, so flat 9.
Yep.
Oh.
No, nothing.
Why don't I have any bonuses? Whoa.
Oh.
I can't do
anything. Oh, that's a big relief for me. I was like, goodbye, Calypso.
I can't do anything today.
All right, so that was it for the sevens. I go now. I've got 2 5s. My first 5 is a 5-5, the Calypso. She's going to use Siren Song. Now, the way Siren Song works, for those of you who are new to the game, or those of you who just who've been playing ISS, you might not know this. The Calypso card states under Siren Song that it's 4 auto-hit attacks, and it's range 2 card lengths. It can only be used once per game. That was put on the FAQ. They had a pretty atrocious misprint here. The way Siren Song works is you use it. It actually uses adjusted line of sight. In this case, that's not actually happening. Adjusted line of sight is the same line of sight that grenades use. If a buddy can see an enemy that's within range of the Calypso can fire Siren Song and will hit all targets within 2 card lengths. And it even goes behind the Calypso. No one is safe. These missiles, the Siren Song missiles, launch from her shoulder. They've been described as merc-seeking missiles. They hunt mercs down and they find them. So let's say hypothetically, I'm going to take the Marshal here for you. I'm going to put the Marshal down right over here behind this truck. I can't see the Marshal, but the Marshal is within 2 card lengths. The missiles will wrap around the vehicle and strike the Marshal. Siren Song is nuts. So, in this case, we have 2 enemies within 2 card lengths, the Jaguar in here, and I've actually got this great tool I can just whip out. So the only enemies, Leader and Jaguar. So each of them takes 2 blood, and each of them rolls 2 armor failure checks. Start with the Leader.
Yep, for the Leader, 2 5, so armor broke.
And then Jaguar. Oh, Jaguar's broken too.
I think that's pretty much a game.
I don't know, this could still... You got the Eagle running and the Heavy. I don't know. I have the... Oh, you know what? I squandered an opportunity here for my Overwatch on your Heavy.
I don't think I can save you, dude.
Oh, I got you there. Oh.
Wait,
never mind, you are blocked. I'm quite wrong. Cut that from the video.
Yeah, you are.
I'm never wrong!
You want to see me?
Okay, so 5-4 with the Leader. My leader's
the rest,
gonna.
The rest of your guys got.
Yeah.
My two. So.
My leader's gonna unload on the back of your Eagle, and he's just gonna. He's gonna stay where he is. He starts at FN7, short range, rear, no cover. We're looking at 2s. I hit twice. That's 2 blood.
and 4 armor failure checks because of his special ammunition. He has a special ammo type called Flechette Brown, so that's broken.
Yeah, so it's broken.
Yeah, man, 3 armor breaks in this round.
That's a game.
I've got Sniper and Demolition going at the same time again. So the Demolition's got a fire move, and the Sniper is, I think the Sniper is just going to shoot. So I'll start with this. Shots, because it's simultaneous, in their mind, I can technically do them in any order, but I'm just going to break it down and do everything accordingly. Shots will be fired at halfway through the movement round of down. So I'll start right here with the snap to cover with the demo. He's going to move 1 MP here. Right here, she's going to snap and fire at the eagle. The eagle's in half cover. I will need a 6 to hit the eagle. I miss. The Demolition is going to move another MP right over here. And now, shoot. He can fire in melee. He actually gets 2 shots as long as he's within short range, and melee counts for that. It's his rear back here. Because
I used pretty much the...
The feet? Okay. Yeah. So that'll be 5s to hit. Yeah. 1 hit. Yeah. So that's 1 more blood.
1 more blood. He has 4 blood.
Yep. And with that, I am done. So you got a 2 with the eagle.
Great. Can't believe I did not hit with the Calypso. Alright, I'm going to shoot at the Calypso for 8.
7s and half cover make it 8.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
One hit.
I take a blood.
Roll an armor failure check. 4 up, I believe. Ah! No. She's not moving. It's okay. She got Siren Song off.
Yeah.
She is no longer of use to me.
Yeah.
Unless she can roll high enough to stab that guy in the back. Eventually useful. I'm going to use Be My Guest. Swap the initiative of my leader and my sniper. So my sniper will be going at initiative 7-5.
Okay.
So
Eagle is going to do the action that I want to do.
Okay, so he's going to turn with light on my feet, 180.
So light on my feet, 180, and then move 1 MP over here.
Typically, the only way that you can change facing is if you have an MP, but Pat has used his light on my feet PA to let him change facing before a move.
Okay. So that is the Eagle's movement.
So to start, let's take that shot at the heavy, 6 up. Sniper cannot hit today. Hasn't hit once. And then I will snap backwards into the cover of darkness. Over here, I'm going to move 1 MP. Right here. I now have this guy in his rear, but he's got half cover now because he's partially blocked by that box. So I'll be looking at 5s to him in the rear. And I got him, so he goes down with that last blood.
He's dead.
I'm going to use my other MP to change elevations. I'm going right here.
Alright, my leader is at 7-4, so okay. He's going to take a shot for the Calypso.
Okay, no cover, so you're looking at 4s. Because you're claiming this cover here, so it won't block, because you're within a base length of it.
And 4 up. Did not hit her, yeah, so I'm getting focused fire. 4
dead.
Up.
Dead. She falls.
Take a crack shot at her.
Need a move. He's going to backpedal. No, I got to play around your gunner, or you're just going to light me up. I'm going to move 1 MP. I'll go like this. I'll go 1 MP over here.
And just for your reference, my rear is away from the gun.
That's fine. I'm just going to go right here.
Okay. I got to paint. I keep forgetting to paint the...
Should I move 1 more MP? Yeah, you know, I'm going to use my other MP. I'm going to go right here. But you'll probably just run away from me. That's fine. See, if I'm in his rear, I get minus 2 FN. Plus 2 weapon strength, and that will make my weapon strength 4 against his armor 3, so I can do some damage.
I'm going to snap back to your dude, and I'm going to hit him with the machete.
Am I in your arc? Can you actually see me?
Oh.
If you snap a 30 millimeter base, because hang on.
Yeah, I think if I snap all the way back, I can. Like that.
No, no. You have to occupy the new space. Yeah. Okay, so you can do it.
Yeah.
What's the strength of your machete?
Two.
Okay. Well, what is your bonus to melee?
Nothing. So I'm
no,
eight.
You need an 8. Yeah.
Yeah. Swing wildly and a miss.
Oh. Okay. So I think that wraps up our turn 5. No, turn 6. So we're looking at the last turn here. It's going to come down to control points in just a second. So that demolition, at this point, he's going to fire and move. He's going to move this way. He's going to stop flush with the elevation change, turn 90 degrees, and he's going to fire. And I am in short range. Now, typically the dog would come out and attack, but I'm ER3. The dog can't climb a truck. So we don't have to worry about that. So from this position, IMF and 8, we're talking about short range, half cover, elevation. I get 2 shots at 6 up. And that does it. Then the leader goes and falls. I'm gonna bound with my sniper to my leader. I am willing to flip for trap cards in this instance because he's not gonna die. He'll just get trapped, which means I hold the zone. But otherwise, he'll get 3 MP and he can run back and claim my home zone and get points at the end. So that's what he did. Go ahead with your eagle.
Alright. There's no really use shooting your demo because I won't be able to kill him anyway. Yeah, it's last turn. It's last turn, right?
This will be the last turn.
Yeah. So he is going to attempt to shoot at him.
Him? Okay.
7s, no cover, 6s.
He's in half cover all times because of his
shield.
So he will actually be 8s.
8s.
Yep. And then he's got...
Of course, I just can't connect.
Alright.
And then you got a 6 with a heavy gunner. Hit me.
There's nothing else to do.
You can hold if you want. I mean, at this point...
It doesn't matter.
So yeah.
For my pride.
8 up.
Yep.
No.
Come on, I can't connect with anything.
Alright, so ready for this? We have some fun here.
Yep.
You go with my leader, who is just going to... I don't know. He's going to hold. There's no point in shooting. I can't actually kill your guy.
Yeah.
So, that's the unfortunate thing about having turn limits. But, you've got your trap cards, right?
So move half your MP.
I move half my MP. I'm going to start with a backpedal move. Yeah, so that'll be a 2 MP move.
But that's...
Half my MP rounded down, so I flip immediately.
Oh.
Makes sense?
Yeah.
So I'm actually going to start with a snap first, so I snap back. Now, I would move half of my MP rounded down before the traps hit. I move 3 MP, but I'm going to backpedal with my first move. So because half my MP rounded down would be 1, and I'm going to backpedal, I need to flip now. So let's see him, Pat. Put him down, put him down. The force is with me.
Come on.
Ah, trigger trap. Yeah. All right, roll on that table. Roll on that table.
So now I roll on the table detailed here.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
7.
What does that do? Gas trap. Last 2 rounds. Weapon strength 2 for the first round, 1 for the last. Blood 1. Minus 1 MP. No! No! That's the whole reason I did this. Sorry. All right, so he'll take, what was it? Strength 2 hit,
yeah,
1 blood.
Take a blood.
Now, I'm going to, I guess, backpedal this far. And unfortunately, here's my border for the line. I need to make it past. I need to be completely on this side. If you're ever on the border, you count as being in the zone with more points because this zone is worth 2. This is worth 3. I don't actually make it away. But I do have 2 guys in this zone here. That's 3 victory points for me. Looking over here, Pat actually controls this zone. That's 2 victory points for him. I have killed 3 of Pat's mercs. That brings my total up to 6. And Pat has killed 2 of mine. That brings us total to 4. So the game 6-4. That's it. Good game, Pat. All right. Thanks for watching.